Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
A French dog breed whose origin dates back to the late 16th century, the Beauceron was a farm dog used for protecting and herding sheep and cattle. Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, and this is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please, I'll go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In this video, I will be giving you my brief breed review of the Beauceron. Originally bred in France, the Beauceron was used to herd and protect large flocks of sheep. Now, the breed is so good at its job, it has been known to move sheep upwards of 50 miles a day and not be tired. Although they are quite different in appearance, the Beauceron and the long-haired sheepdog, the Briard, they stem from similar ancestral stock. Both of them share the trait of double dew claws on their hind legs. Both breeds were used to herd sheep and cattle. Like the Beauceron, the Briard is found throughout northern France. Beauceron is a very versatile and capable working and dog sport canine. The breed stands at 61 to 70 centimeters, that's 24 to 27 and a half inches in height, and weighs between 30 and 45 kilograms or 66 to 100 pounds. The Beauceron's coloring is black and tan or gray black and tan called merle. Although most breeds may or may not have dew claws, obviously many owners of dogs remove their dew claws. An important feature of the Beauceron is its double dew claws. In order to be shown, a Beauceron must have double dew claws that form and well-separated thumbs with nails on each of its rear legs. Anything less will result in disqualification of the dog from confirmation shows. In regards to the Beauceron's temperament and personality, this is an athletic, healthy, and long-lived dog breed. The breed has been bred to be intelligent, calm, gentle, and fearless. Adult Beaucerons are typically suspicious of strangers and are excellent natural guard dogs. On the other hand, the breed also typically takes their cues from their owners when it comes to greeting strangers, and they are neither sharp nor shy. So in terms of my recommendation for the Beauceron, this is a breed that I give four thumbs up, if you guys get that. This is a great breed, great dog breed. If you are the type of person that loves getting something a little off center, or like you like to kind of, walk your own path, and you look at everyone else with the Malinois, the German Shepherds, and you say, you know what, I want to do something different. Well, look into the Beauceron. These dogs are great. Everything that the German Shepherd is and everything that the Malinois is, maybe not so much as an intense driving energy of a Malinois, but intelligence, work ethic, athleticism. Beaucerons are amazing dogs. Now, I'm not exactly certain as to why this breed has not caught on with police and military applications, but I do know that the Beauceron is used extensively throughout Europe and even the United States as watchdogs, guard dogs, and also rescue dogs. Today's Beauceron also has the skills of its original purpose, herding. So they're great herders as well. So in addition to being amazing protection animals, they're amazing herding dogs. And if you guys have had the chance to watch a video I've done living with the Beauceron, you met Lauren Trathan, who is a big fan of Beauceron and owns Beaucerons. She's also an ex-military vet, or she's a military vet, I guess. And she had suffered some injuries during her time with the military. Now she suffers from seizures. Her Beauceron has the abilities to actually detect the onset of seizures and give her early warnings, which I found amazing. Also, I will say that the connection between Lauren and her dog was, I've met a lot of people. I've done a lot of documentaries. I would have to say that relationship, it was inspiring to say the least. And probably one of the biggest reasons why I hold the breed, the Beauceron, in such high esteem. What that dog has done for her is amazing. And what I've seen the dog do outside of her, she does herding with her dog. She does protection work with her dog. And I've seen other Beaucerons do the same work, and I've seen other Beauceron owners in that relationship. You don't see a lot of Beaucerons out in the street. This is a very, I wouldn't say it's a rare breed, but there's not a lot of Beauceron around, especially I know from going to AKC shows, you know, you never really will find more than three or four of them in a ring at a time, unless you're at probably a Beauceron special. But like I said earlier, if you're someone who likes to walk a different path, you like to walk off the beaten path, the rarity of this breed would be an added bonus for you. You'll walk around with a beautiful dog. This dog is very majestic, incredible size and presence that, you know, you'll get a lot of attention, and people will have to stop and ask you, like, exactly what kind of dog is that. In regards to finding a breeder, obviously, I'm going to say it like I always say it in every other video, got to do your research. You have to make sure that you're finding a breeder that is health testing your Beauceron. Again, health testing is just, it just is what it is. It's just kind of the fundamental thing that I think, you know, every dog starts with. If you want to bring a dog into your home, you're going to want it to be as healthy and happy for as long as possible. Well, that all starts with health testing. You're going to be spending your money. You want to get value for your money. You want a healthy dog. A healthy dog means more years alive, less vet bills, more value. Not that that should be your key thing, but it should be an important thing because it works out well for you as well as for the dog. And it works out for the breed itself, right? More healthy dogs around, the better experience people have with the dogs, the more healthy and thriving the breed gets to be. All right, guys, in terms of health issues for this breed, again, you know, hip elbow dysplasia. I do believe that cardiomyopathy is also a thing, but you know, do your research, find a breeder that's screening for these things. Nothing is 100%, but if you do your proper precautions, your screenings, you can definitely mitigate the chances that your dog will suffer from any of these diseases. All right. Thanks again, guys, for watching. This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace. Your own style, that's just slang for you ain't got